Hey, it's old Big Bob. Big Bob. How are you? So, I'm just thinking back to my first marriage and to the mother-in-law who really started a lot of shit going down. And yeah, I swore. Oh my God. So, really, just insanity. And the chaos that she seemed to embrace. I am just so amazed and so happy to finally kind of get a grip on what happened and to begin to see, thanks to Dennis Prager and Prager U, the my sunglasses, I gotta have sunglasses, I don't have sunglasses, I'm in trouble, all right, and my son needs to have sunglasses too. I wonder if he has them. I'll have to tell my son here. All right, here we go. Remember your sunglasses, son. Sunglasses. Do you need sunglasses? I hope you have your sunglasses. Remember, sunglasses. Well, I told him what I was going to tell him. I told him, and I told him what I told him. So there you go. That's it. Oh, my cup. I got to get my cup ready. Here it is. Got my UCLA cup. Hopefully they'll fill it back up again. If they don't, then oh well. So, the whole idea that chaos, and that I was seen as being chaotic because my life was, and I grew up with chaos. Growing up, I absolutely sought, with every fiber of my being, I sought to organize and to clean. That's my whole life's been about that. I painted the house. I did the garden. I took care of all the details. Even as a child, I was painting and cleaning and working and I remember making a decision when I first got married. There was a lady that I really was very happy to know. At her house, they had plastic on top of the counters. And the to protect the formica. And I thought, well, that's kind of wild. You've got formica, and you've got plastic, and you've got, you know, they couldn't just have the regular counter. They had to have, it just seemed kind of totally too much. I thought, well, you know, Diana, my first wife, I could help there. There was something to do. And I kind of got it. I got the whole routine where I had to help, be helpful. It's interesting. But having a conversation would have been good. I could have had a conversation about, gee, Carol, her name was Carol Smith. And that's just a general name. I don't think I'm revealing any great sources or anything. But Carol Smith's family, they had the kitchen, and it was so clean. They had stuff on top of stuff on top of stuff. Three layers of protection. They never once but dream of, they never once would dream of enjoying the actual countertop. It was like the old deal with the Italians. They, that guy's a nut. Should have just come up here off the freeway. Should never change the tire on the freeway, ever. Run on your rim. It's not worth your life. Get off of the freeway. Go to a side street somewhere. Don't ever, ever, ever change a tire on a freeway. So my house as a kid was chaos. Total chaos. I mean, just, and my dad, even today, is chaos. Just rampant disaster. You even look at his arms and legs, and it's a disaster. Cuts and scrapes and bleeding, and, you know, look at my arm. See, my arm is in good shape. I protect it. I'm very careful. I think that's important, to be careful. Not to be overly controlling. I just talked about that with my friends from the club. And my philosophy with child raising, I've got 4 children of my own and 2 other children. They got 6 kids altogether. And my philosophy of raising children is to make them as strong, not make them, allow them to be as strong as they can be. Allow them to experience, allow them to climb, allow them to fall, allow them to, and not off of a cliff, not into a glass factory with shards of glass. They're gonna get their juggler. And, well, he said he wanted to learn how to fall. I'm talking about a baby, you know, who tips over. Little Bethany Rose, she'll tip over sometimes. And, oh my God! You know what? She's all right. She goes flat on her face. She just lays there and I tickle her. You know, she knows. She's getting better, you know. So, well, give me a call. 213-713-8954. 8954 green at att.net. On the Twitter, Mr. Bob at Bob8954. And of course, you're watching Bob's Daily Diva here on YouTube. Where, good to see you, pumpkin. There you go, jackass. Yeah. Some moronic idiot honking at me. What are you honking for? You? Yeah. See, she's racing now. I'm watching her. She's up there at the red light and she's crying her eyes out. She's up there at the red light crying her eyes out. Yep, she's just weeping like a little baby. She can't go fast enough. She wants to go faster and faster and faster and faster. I'm going to go so fast that my skin will fly off of my body. That's how fast I want to go. Well, I don't want to go that fast. I don't need to go that fast. I want to go just fast enough to get up the road. All righty. All right, call me soon. Love you. Bye.